Hello Jackalls! Today we'll take a look how to split red, green and blue channel in DaVinci Resolve. Why? Because I think it's a cool effect. Now let's get digital. You can apply this effect to a video or an image. In this case I'll just be using an image that is transparent, and I'll add a background to it and change the color just so we can see the difference. Then select the image and we'll do the effect in the Fusion page. Now in the Fusion page, to split the channels, we'll use a new node, or at least a node that you might not be using a lot. It's called Channel Booleans. We'll connect it just like this. And you'll want to make two copies and connect each one individually. You can also rename the nodes if you want with F2. So this one can be called red, green and blue, because each one will be for a different channel. Now when you select the node, I'll just display it on the left side. You can see we have red, green and blue and the alpha. We'll have to set the other two channels to black. So this one is black and this one is black. So now we have the red channel. Here we'll have the green channel. And the last one will be the blue channel. So we have the blue channel, the green channel and the red channel. Next, to move this, we'll need a transfer node, and we'll need a transfer node for each of them, and basically we'll be moving the X and Y values, just like that. So I'll make a copy of these transforms as well and connect each one individually like that. And lastly, we want to merge this, but you can't use the transfer node because you won't get the result that you want. Even if you would change the apply mode to something else, as you can see. So instead of the merge node, we'll be using the channel booleans again. Simply connect the first two, make a copy, and then connect the last one and the output of this one, and then this will go to the media out. Now to get any kind of difference, what we need to do is set the operation from copy to add. This will now turn to what we have originally. But the difference is, now if you go to the transfer node and change the value, look at that. So you can animate each individual value, and depending on how you move the positions, you'll get different colors. So I'll put these values back to default. Now you have a couple of options how to animate the center X and Y positions in the transfer nodes, but the option that I'll use is the Reactor plugin, and I'll be using the audio plugin within the Reactor. So I'll be leaving this link so you can download it, and the Reactor 3 is out, but I think I have this one installed, the version 2. So once you install it, and if it doesn't open, go to Workspace, Scripts, Reactor and open it. This might take a while. Once you have this opened, type in Audio, install the Sockless Audio, and you may need to restart DaVinci Resolve. And why I installed Sockless Audio is because I want to sync this effect to music. Now when you have the plugin installed, click on the transfer node, right click on the center position, go to modify with, and you'll see an option, audio. And for this to work, you need a WAV file. Then the modifier tab shows up, and you can specify the file. So I'll just simply use a quick audio file. As you can see now, the red channel is way off, and I can adjust it with the amplitude. So 0.1. So maybe something like that, but if I play this over just a bit, you can see that this actually moves diagonally. And if I go back to the tool so that we can see the positions, you can see that we actually move both the X and Y direction, which is maybe not what you want. So to fix that, I'll just remove this. You could use a custom tool. So custom tool. Now in the custom tool, you could use just the number in, right click it and modify it with the audio wave. Once you have the file in, you would simply maybe pin it just like that. Go to the transform. Then you would give this an expression and you just modify one of the values. Because this is a point, so you have the X position and the Y position. So in this case, we could animate the Y position. And I actually have to pin this one, not the modifier step, so that I can see it. And this is the name of the tool, custom tool 1, numpre in. So this all works, but if you want to see any changes, I'll actually have to put in the audio file. And now this only moves in the Y direction, as you can see. I could then simply switch this around. Say this will be the X value and put 0.5 here. This will now move in the X direction. And similarly, since I have this pinned, well, I have it pinned now, I can go to this transform, go to the center position, make an expression, and simply drag it down here. Now, because these two transforms have the same value in the position, they have the same position. So if you don't want that, we could maybe subtract a point. In this case, we only need to subtract the X value, so maybe 0.05. And the Y is 0 because we don't have any offset, but if we want to have it, we could also do it. But you don't need to use the custom tool to sync this up. So in this transfer node, I'll go to the center, modify width, and choose XY path. The modifier tab also shows up. As you can see, we have both the X and Y values keyframed, so we can simply disable this. Then right click on the value that we want to animate. Maybe in this case, we want to animate it in the Y direction. And now we'll simply modify it with the audio file. Now simply do this as before. Import the audio, use 0.1. You can also specify the range of the frequency. So now the first two channels are moving left and right, and the blue channel is moving up and down. But let's fix that. So I'll be removing the custom tool. Now that we have animated only the X position by using the XY path, in this transform, we can do the same for these ones. I could also use the expression, but if I did that and connect it to this center position, that would basically have the same value. But I don't want that. So with this transform selected, go to the modifiers and pin the transform XY path. Then select this transform, right click on the center and modify it with XY path. Then go to the modifiers and you'll have both of this X and Y position keyframed. I'll simply disable them. Because this is animated in the X value, I'll animate this one in the Y value. I'll simply make an expression and drag it to the X value. So the blue channel will move in the X direction, the green channel in the Y direction, and red channel. Well, let's go to Tools, right click center, modify with XY path. And this one can also move in the X direction. So let's make equals X direction, but what we can do is put one in front and minus that. And because all of the animation is actually happening in this node, we can go to the audio wave and adjust the amplitude offset if we want. So maybe 0.1 and the amplitude offset is 0.5. So now we have everything in center. Now this is how the effect looks like at the end, but if you want to have the original image overlapped, we can add a merge node, and this will be in front. So this is how the effect looks like. If you want to tone down the effect, we could maybe add a polygon. I'll make a quick outline. You can do it like this, and in the polygon you would adjust the soft edge. But in my case, because I have an image that is transparent, I can simply use a bitmap. connect this like that. As you can see, this just makes a mask. I'll connect it inside here, and now I can simply adjust the soft edge to what I want. And now if I go back and wait for this to render out, now this is what I ended up with, and as you can see, I don't actually have any audio on the timeline. The audio that you use in the effect, you then also have to put on the timeline. And this effect can also be used to spice up music videos. But in this example, I didn't include the audio because I don't want to have any issues. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you want to get more DaVinci Resolve and video editing content. And hit the bell notification icon so you know when my next video comes out. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackalls, keep it digital!